class 10. Today I am again with you with a new chapter, Control and Coordination. This is a very interesting chapter and I am divided the chapter into various parts, various topics. So I will upload the various type of videos on these parts. Today's topic is about coordination in plant. So watch it and try to understand. Hope you will like the video and the content of the video. My dear children of class 10, today I am going to discuss about the new chapter for you in biology, control and coordination. This chapter is also a bit lengthy like the previous chapter, life processes. Here I am going to divide this chapter into various parts and I will be uploading the various videos related to the various topics. The first topic there I will discuss today is called coordination. Here in this part of coordination, you will learn about the introductory part, various type of key terms related to the coordination. Then come the coordination in plants. So this is the first video today I am going to discuss. Second video I will be telling you about control and coordination in animals and nervous coordination in animals. The third video will be only about division of nervous system, generally human nervous system. The fourth one will be human brain. Fifth video will be about spinal cord. Thereafter the sixth video I will upload about the chemical coordination in animals, generally hormones, the endocrine system. And then come the feedback mechanism, the part A7, and finally the chemical coordination in plants. So keep watching till the end of the video. So let me begin with the very definition of coordination. What do you mean by coordination? It is the ability to use different parts of the body together smoothly and efficiently. Now here I am going to describe this definition with three examples that we perform very often. The three activities are writing, dancing and cycling. Now just see how I am explaining it. Writing. While you write, what do? You use your fingers. You have a grip on the pen or pencil that you are using with the fingers. Your eyes help to write down and see what you are writing. If there is any error in writing, you just correct it or rectify it. So your eyes are working and you're thinking. You're thinking what you're writing exactly. So your fingers, eyes and the thinking part, which is mainly controlled by the brain, is going on. In case of dancing, your legs, feet, hand, whole body, as well as facial expressions are changing every now and then. So all these body activities are together coordinated well to perform a dance. In case of cycling, your legs are paddling, your eyes are looking forward, that whether some vehicles are coming from ahead, and your body posture, you're maintaining the posture on the seat of the cycle. So all these activities are going on together in a well coordinated manner. So this is what is known as coordination. I hope you understood what is the definition of coordination with the help of three examples that I have just described here. You can even give more examples if you like. So here are the keywords. The first keyword, irritability. Now what do you mean by irritability? All living organisms has the ability to detect changes in the external as well as internal environment. Internal environment means the internal body environment. And these organisms, they respond and react appropriately though to these changes that take place in the external as well as internal environment. So such an ability of an organism to react to such changes is called irritability. Now you see the next key term is stimuli. The singular is the stimulus. Now stimuli or stimulus is the change in the environment. So if it is the changes in the environment, it becomes stimuli, the plural form of stimulus. Now come the receptor organs or receptors or sense organs. Now the organs that detect the stimuli, they are called sense organs. What is a response? Now response is the reaction shown by a living organism to this stimuli. So these are the various type of keywords related to the coordination in plants and animals. Now let's have a look about the coordination. So here I am describing three examples of coordination of various plants and animals. First example is drooping of leaves in mimosa plant. Mimosa plant is called touch me not.
or Lajwanti plant. This plant droops the leaf when we touch it. So here the touch is the stimulus that is sensed by the leaves of the mimosa. So the mimosa plant is sensing the touch and it is responding against the touch by drooping the leaves. Second example is our eyes get closed when bright light falls on them. So yes, bright light is the stimulus and the closing of eyes is the response. The hands, our hands are withdrawn when we place them on hot objects. So withdrawing of hand is the response and the hot object is the stimulus. So in this way, you can understand here the examples of coordination and stimulus and response. Here you see coordination is seen in animals in two ways. Animals have both nervous system and endocrine system. So both work together to coordinate the various functions of the body. This is together known as neuroendocrine system. But in case of animals, plants do not have any nervous system. So how do they coordinate with the environment? They coordinate with the hormones, which are biological chemicals or phytohormones. So here I am going to describe about coordination in plants. Now in plants, you know, stimulus is the agent, that is the change in the environment, the agent or the change in the environment that caused the movement or some sort of response in the plant is called the stimulus. The perceptive region, the plant region that perceives and detects the stimulus or the change in the environment is the perceptive region. The response, the reaction of the plant to the stimulus perceived, and the responsive region, the part of the plant which responds or shows response to the stimulus. So these are the various terms associated with the reference of coordination in plants. Now let's have a example. Now you see, if I take the example of touch me not, as I was telling you before, here the stimulus is the touch, the perceptive region is the leaflet of the touch me not plant. You know, the leaves are compound leaves in touch me not, so there are leaflets. The perceptive regions are leaflets. Now what happens to this perceptive region, the leaflets? In response, they fold the leaflets, so the leaves fold, and the responsive region is the folded leaves. Now why these leaves fold? Because of the cells which gain or lose the turgidity at the base of the leaflet. So this is the reason why they fold the leaves. So this is about the coordination in plants with the help of an example. Now let's look about the various type of responses in the plants. Finally, the last topic of the video is the types of stimulus in plants. So plants have two types of stimulus: induced stimulus, which is known as paratonic stimulus, and spontaneous stimulus, which is also known as autonomic stimulus. So here I am going to discuss about the paratonic movement or paratonic or induced stimulus or induced movement in the plants. So induced movement in the plants are of two types: tropic movement and nastic movement. Tropic movement are again divided into five types. They are phototropic movement, this is the movement of the plant parts towards the light; geotropic movement, that is the movement of the plant parts towards gravity; hydrotropism, movement that is towards water; chemotropism is the movement due to chemical stimulus; and thigmotropism is movement due to contact or touch stimulus. Now tropic movement is directional movement and growth dependent movement. So this is very vital, you have to remember, tropic movement are always growth related movement and directional movement. Next come the nastic movement. Here nastic movement are non-directional movement and growth independent movement. This is a very basic difference between nastic and tropic movement. So there are about seven types of nastic movements. These are seismonasty, that is the nastic movement due to response to touch; photonasty, movement in response to light; thermonasty, movement of plant parts in response to heat or temperature; nictinastic, sleep movements in plant; hydronasty, water stress condition or folding of the grass in response to drought; chemonasty, movement in response to a chemical; and finally epinasty, that is bending movement due to growth. Students, I hope you understood about the stimulus in plants. So every type of tropic movement is very important. So in later video, in one other video, I will discuss about all the types of tropic movement with various activities related to it. So watch the latter videos, which are only about dropping movement and nesting movement.
So my dear students, hope you like the video. If you have liked the video, please don't do any misery to keep a big like. If you have liked it, then do share it with your friends so that everybody get benefited. And please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay happy. Bye.